Hi student, I am Dr. D.S. Thore. Now, I share the screen of today's lecture in front of you. Welcome to the ninth lecture of course number PAC 354. That is diseases of field and horticultural crops and their management. In today's lecture, we discuss two important diseases seen in sorghum and maize crop. So first of all, we discuss the anthrax disease of sorghum. Okay, so this is the most important and severe disease seen in Andhra Pradesh, Delhi, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, and Karnataka. Means this anthracnose disease is the most common disease seen in every variety grown in India. Okay, so the losses caused by this disease seen in sorghum up to 20 to 30%, because these type of the symptoms majorly seen on well matured plants. So number of the symptoms seen on the all the aerial plant parts of the sorghum plants, means this type of the infection seen on the leaf portion, leaf seed, stalk or stem portion, as well as airhead having the grains. So this grains is also infected by the fungus and showing the number of the symptoms. Okay, so we go to the symptom points of this anthracnose disease. So this type of the infection or symptoms majorly seen on the lower side of the leaf, means initially infection seen on the lower side of the leaf, but gradually these infections or progress of this infection or disease from lower side to the upper side. Means these anthracnose symptoms mainly seen on the both side of the leaf. Okay, so initially small water soaked or semi transparent oval spots may be seen on the leaf of these sorghum plants. Okay, but under favorable conditions these small spots grows or enlarge on the leaf lamina of this leaf. So these spots become enlarges with border. So these borders generally red to orange or somewhat purple in colors. Okay, so you see these individual lesions developed by the anthracnose pathogen on this leaf. So these lesions having the border generally red in colors, and center portion generally necrotic, means this tissue become infected by the pathogens and develop the necrotic symptoms. So these necrotic lesions surround by the red margins or maybe orange margins or maybe purple margins. So this color of the borders, it depends upon the variety of the sorghums. Okay, so under favorable conditions these maximum blight lesions may be coalesced to each others So, majorly portion of the leaf having the blight appearance. So these blight lesions become necrotic. Means in this way, number of the leaf showing anthracnose symptoms means blight appearance symptoms generally seen on the number of the leaf produced by the sorghum plants. Okay, so these plants looks like as a burn appearance, means a burning type of the symptoms generally seen in these sorghum plants. Okay, in last stage of the infection, so this center portion become black in colors. So this black color represent as a formation of the acerola spore fruits. Means this is the asexual spore fruits produced by the conidia. Means already conidia is produced in this blackish lesions, may be developed in the center portion of these lesions. Okay, so this type of the infection generally seen on the leaf of the sorghums. Then these infections or these pathogens may be spread from leaf to the stem portion or culm portion, or may be infect to these airheads. Okay, means already conidia is produced in these infected lesions, may be developed on the leaf. Okay, so this conidia is rain flash or through wind and just fallen on these stem portions. So initially the water soaked translucent reddish spots generally seen on the stem portion. So these lesions or these spots just spread in the upward direction or downward direction, means on the surface of the stem portions, goes in the upward direction or maybe downward direction. So majority portion of the stems infect by this pathogen and showing the reddish or somewhat brownish lesions. Okay, so same type of the infection also be seen on this panicle and also the airhead portions. Okay, so these lesions or these reddish lesions may be seen on these panicles as well as the grain develop in the infected airheads. Okay, suppose the infected panicle is a split, so area of the red discolor infected tissue may be seen, and this red tissue generally differ from the healthy one white tissues. Okay, so in last stage of the infection, black acerola spore fruits may be seen or produced on the surface of the stem as well as on the surface of the airheads. Okay, so in this way, this anthracnose pathogen develop the symptoms on the leaf, on this stem portion, on this leaf seed, then panicle portion, and also the grains in the particular airheads. Okay, so this is the symptoms developed by the anthracnose pathogens. Okay, but in same conditions, these sorghum plants is also infected by the some pathogens, that is Cercospora or Helminthosporium, and develop the same type of the symptoms like as the anthracnose on the infected plants. Okay, means on visual or with your naked eyes, you cannot properly identify the symptoms produced either by the anthracnose pathogen, means Colopetricum pathogens, or maybe Helminthosporium pathogen or Cercospora pathogens. Okay, so you properly determine or finding the which type of the pathogens infect to these sorghum plants and develop such type of the symptoms. Okay, so you can isolate this fungus in laboratory and see the spores and spore bearing hyphae under the microscope, then you can confine finally the pathogens which is causing to the sorghum and produces the reddish or brownish lesions. Okay, then we go to the next point, that is the causal organisms, that is the Colototricum graminicolum. This fungus mainly responsible to produce the such type of the infection on the sorghum plants. Okay, so this Colototricum graminicolum fungus develop the mycelia. So this mycelia is always haline. Haline means colorless. Then septate means cross wall, generally present within this cell of this mycelium. Okay, so this mycelia is always white to dull white in colors. Okay, so this mycelia develop the spore fruits, and this spore fruit is known as the acervala. So acervala is a asexual spore fruit in which conidiophore and conidia generally produce. Conidia is asexual spores produced within the acervalae, asexual spores, sorry, spore fruits. Okay, so you see this disease cycle or life cycle of this anthracnose pathogens, that is the Colototricum graminicolum or graminicola. Okay, so this is the infected plants on which leaf and somewhat these airheads. So these leaf and airheads infect by the Colototricum pathogens. So develop the conidia. Means after harvest of the sorghum plants from these main fields, so some of the crop residues generally fallen on the soil. Okay, means these spores and spore bearing hyphae, means fungus overwinters as a mycelium in the seeds or plant debris or maybe fallen in the soil. Means primary infection generally takes place through use of the infected seeds, because these as anthracnose pathogen also infect to the developing the airheads having the grains. So such infected grain generally used for sowing purpose. So 100% this is produced. Then plant debris means some of the leaf or maybe whole plants generally debris in the soil. So in this way, the healthy plants become infected by various ways, that is by using the infected seeds or plant debris or in the soils. Okay, so these fungus germinate under the favorable conditions if the farmers can sow the seeds of the sorghum in the same field. Okay, so these spores directly infect to the leaf of the sorghum and produce the acervala spore fruits, means spores bearing hyphae, that is a conidiophore, and conidia is produced. So this is the conidia. Means this conidia generally falcate shape. Means both the end of this cell is always tapered. Okay, and bulbous base generally seen on the middle portion of these cells. Okay, so this conidia means number of the conidia generally released from this acerbalized spore roots and thallus on the healthy one host tissue through wind or air currents. So this conidia germinate under the favorable conditions and penetrate to this healthy one leaf of the sorghums. So this healthy one host tissue become infect, means actually pathogen penetrate within this healthy one host tissue. So this healthy one host tissue become infected. So in this way, the initial infection generally seen on the lower side of the leaf of these sorghum plants. Okay, so in this way we complete the life cycle of the Colocotricum graminivorum. Okay, you see this photograph. So this is the acerbalized spore fruits. Okay, so this acerbalized spore fruits generally produces the conidia. So you see this conidia. So this conidia generally falcates conidia having the oil globules ring may be seen in these conidial cells. Okay, so in between the two conidiophore, one sterile structure may be arise, and this structure is known as the city. Okay, so this city initially brown in color, but final stage this brown color turns to the black in color. Means this acerbalized spore fruits generally produces the conidia, conidiophore and sterile black city. So this structure generally produced within the acerbalized spore fruits. Okay, then next point, that is a barbiturations. Means already I discussed this barbituration in the life cycle of this disease. So primary infection takes place through the use of the infected seeds, infected plant part debris in the soil, and secondary infection, that is a conidia. So this conidia disseminated from infected plant to the healthy one plants through wind or air currents. Okay, and last one, control media. Means how to control this type of the disease seen on the sorghum, because nearly about 20 to 30% yield is reduced if this type of the symptoms seen on the mature plant. Okay, so first management point should be considered, that is to collect infected plant parts and burn properly. Means after harvest, these infected plant parts collect manually and burn properly. Okay, means to avoid the primary source of infections. Okay, then treat the seed with Captan or Thyrum at the rate of 4 g/kg of seed, because we know the primary infection is takes place through the use of the infected seeds. Means to protect the seed of the sorghum before the actual sowing in the main fields by applying the fungicide, that is a seed treating fungicide, Captan or Thyrum, at the rate of 2 to 4 g/kg of seed. If the various type of the symptoms seen on the sorghum plants, so farmer can use the effective fungicide just applied over these sorghum fields, that is mancozeb 0.3%, or instead of this mancozeb, you also be use that is propiconazole 0.5%. Okay, so in this way you can avoid the anthracnose disease seen on the sorghum plants. Okay, so this is the information of the anthracnose disease seen in the sorghum. Okay, then we go to the next disease of today's lecture, that is a brown spot of maize. Okay, so this disease is also most important disease seen in various countries such as China, Japan, India, and USA. So this brown spot disease was first time found on maize crop cultivated in Bihar, in particularly India, in 1910. But after 1910, this disease is considered as a minor disease. Okay, but recently this disease is a major disease. Okay, in Maharashtra, this brown spot symptoms or brown spot disease generally seen in all the hybrid variety of the maize grown in western Maharashtra and also the Marathwada regions. Recently, in last month, this brown spot disease majorly seen in Aurangabad district in Marathwada region, particularly Maharashtra state. Okay, so this losses generally seen in yield of the maize is near about 15 to 20%. Okay, so this pathogen infect to the leaf portion, leaf blade portion, leaf seed portion, culm portion, and also the husk of the edges. Means mainly this fungus attack or infect to the all the aerial plant parts of the maize plants. Okay, so initially the symptoms seen on the leaf portions. Okay, so you see this infected leaf means these pathogens develop the symptoms firstly on the lower side of the leaf. So you see the lower side of this leaf having the somewhat these yellowish small spots are seen. Okay, so this is the yellowish small spots generally seen on the lower side of this maize leaf. Okay, so these yellowish spots spread to the entire or entire surface of this maize leaf. Means the majority portion of the leaf develop such type of the yellow spots. But under favorable conditions, these yellow spots turns to the reddish brown in color and finally brown in colors. Okay, means yellow color turns to the brown in colors. So these brown lesions or brown spots just seen on this leaf of these maize plants. Okay, so these spots generally 1 mm or maybe except the one enemy. Generally, these spots seen on the stem portion means larger the size of the spots seen on the stem portion as well as the culm portion as compared to the leaf portions. Okay. So, under favorable conditions, large number of the brownish spots seen on the surface of the leaf. So, these affected plants or affected leaf portion become rusty in appearance. Just looks like as a rust disease seen in the mage plants. Okay, then these pathogens or these symptoms mainly spread to the leaf portion to the leaf seed portions. Okay, means same, that is a yellowish to brownish spots also be seen on the leaf seed portion and finally spread the disease also be seen on this node portion or stem portion of these mage plants. Okay, means the brownish spots just seen below the node points. Okay, so these lesions, brownish lesions, is exceed or grows in the upward direction or maybe downward directions. Okay, so this infected leaf seed is totally red in colors. Okay, means this infected portion below these nodes or maybe leaf seed portions. So this infected tissues are generally red in color or maybe brown in colors, means totally weakened tissues seen inside this node portion or inside the stem portions. So such infected plants generally lozenging or stem lozenging occurs, means these infected plants it just break down or just break off from this point of infections. Means already this infected tissue is weakened, so this plant cannot hold the balance from the this point of infections. Okay, so this affected stems just lodged to the soil. Okay, so such a number of the plants or infected plants we just lodged, so heavy damage or heavy yield losses may be seen at these symptoms. Okay, so this is the brown spot symptoms seen on the mage plant. Means generally brown spots seen on the leaf portion, leaf seed portion, culm portion, stem portion, or sometimes this infection also be seen on the husk portion of the mage plants. Okay, then the Physoderma zimae, this is the fungus mainly infect to this mage plant and develop such type of the symptoms. Okay, so this fungus is a intracellular in the host tissue, means this mycelia grows within the host cell, so this is known as the intracellular mycelia. Okay, so this mycelia is always synocytic hyphae, means no any cross wall is present within this mycelium. Okay, So this mycelium connect with large vegetative cells is known as the samezhalin. So they finally produce the asexual spore fruits. This is known as the sporangium. So this sporangium generally arises after the germination of the mycelium. So this sporangium develop the sporangia. So this sporangia is generally released through the wall of the sporangium. So finally, this sporangia is germinate with the help of the moisture and to produce the zoospores. Okay, so these zoospores generally produced in a vesicle structure is arise at the tip of the sporangium. Okay, so the zoospores is always uniflagellate. Okay, then what is the actual perpetuation modes takes place or seen in the brown spot disease in the image? So this Physoderma gymnage, this fungus is an obligate parasite. Obligate parasite means this fungus you cannot isolate in the laboratories. Means they always survival or they require the host plant for survival purpose. Okay, so this is known as the obligate parasites. Okay, so this Physoderma fungus present in the soils. So initially infection generally takes place from the soil. Means after harvest, some crop residues may be debris in the soil. So initial infection takes place from this conidia, emerge out from the infected host tissue and directly fallen on the surface of the leaf. Okay, then secondary infection is always takes place through the sporangia and zoospores, generally produced in the asexual spore fruit that is known as the sporangium. And this sporangia and zoospore disseminated through moisture or maybe irrigation water or somewhat winds. So in this way, spread the disease from infected mage plant to the another healthy one mage plants. Okay? Then we go to the next head, that is a control measures. So in this disease, field sanitation measures or practices generally most effective for control the disease in mage, because primary infection takes place through infected plant debris in the soil or use of the seeds. Okay, then pathogen survival in soil, so crop rotation should be practices. So you know the conidia may be survival in soil in the absence of the mage crop is near about 3 years. Okay, so break down the chain of this conidia by adopting the crop rotation practices with a non-host crop. Then spray the crop with Zynep at the rate of 0.1% or propiconazole at the rate of 0.05%. So minimize the disease incidence during the initial growth of these mage crops. Okay, suppose the disease may be seen on the leaf portion, so immediately you can apply the Zynep fungicide or propiconazole fungicides at proper dose. So in this way you can minimize or you can avoid the Hysoderma fungus attack to the maize crops. And last one, the resistant varieties should be grown. In every year, the number of the varieties, hybrid varieties released by the different countries, different companies and universities. So this variety is somewhat moderately resistant against this Hysoderma leaf spot disease seen in the maize crops. Okay, so in this way you can avoid the Hysoderma leaf spot disease seen in the maize by adopting these four management points. Okay, so in today's lecture, any doubt about these two diseases, that is anthracnose of sorghum and Hysoderma leaf spot of maize? So any query regarding two diseases, so you can ask personally. Okay, so now I end the of the today's lecture. Thank you.